Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our eating streak here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Yesterday's video did not cross 5,000 likes yet, but it's getting there. It's 4,600 right now in the No Seas Challenge. If you want to call that a challenge, it certainly, I mean, you know, sometimes the game just tosses you up a softball. I don't know. Can't blame me for it. But maybe we'll do another one later this weekend. Let's see how this one goes. And let me know in the comments down below if you'd like to see maybe another No Seas run just because. I don't know. Yeah. Put it in the comments. Your meme of the day is going to be brought to you by Manta Raptor. Dothrawos, I really like the pause plus any orbital or something like that. Synergy, not going to lie. And I spent about an hour and a half doodling this. Hope you enjoy. Yes, I do indeed. I can appreciate all the effort that went into not only the characters, but also like the background and stuff too. That's not easy to do. So it's more talent than I'll ever have. Thank you very much, Manta Raptor, and all 63 of y'all who upvoted that one. Go check out the full resolution version on this Invicta subreddit. Here we go. Thank you all very much who tuned in tonight for the stream. Sort of an impromptu Eden stream. 6 X-Ray Hotel 7, Foxtrot Tango Golf Tango. We've got just god-awful tiers. I mean, 1.89 tiers is just awful. Just, ugh. Just get it off my plate. I don't want it. But the good news is that we are starting with decent damage. Pretty bad movement speed, bad range, decent shot speed, but we do have flying and spectral tiers courtesy of Spirit of the Night. We also have the jar. That is not Jar of Flies. That is the jar. It's the one that allows you to hold HP. But yeah, we are going to have to rectify this tiers rate because, man, 1.89 is just, ugh. Just leaves a bad taste in your mouth, man. Also have Curse of the Lost here on Basement 1. But yeah, though, yesterday's video, I mean, again, there's not much to say about it. It was, we did everything that we could to make it a little bit difficult. But that Tech 2 and Ipecac, man, whew. There's one heck of a run. This one here is going to be, I would say, significantly more difficult, only because of the fact that we don't have, not having Ipecac Tech 2 is going to be... Yeah, there's your problem right there. You take out Envy one at a time here. Important thing about Envy, no matter which Envy you're going up against, always go for one chunk at a time. You never really want to go and start fracturing off Envy left and right like this. Unless you have the tiers rate or the piercing shots to back it up. Then it's no problem, but right now we don't. Nice indeed. We'd love to get that tinted rock, of course. We need to get a bomb. Spectral tiers will allow us to shoot through the environment, which is going to be a very, very nice defensive positional advantage. Because then we don't have to worry about, you know, getting in the way of things. We don't have to really poke our heads out and put ourselves in harm's way when we can sit back or over a rock and just fire through it. I mean, it makes things a lot easier, straightforward and stuff. Hoping that we get a bomb here so we can go back and get that tinted rock. We do get a bomb. And sea room should be right there. I'm going to prioritize going for this tinted rock first, though. And well, we got a bomb and a key. Really hoping for another soul heart or even possibly small rock. Although small rock would completely... Oh, yeah. Small rock would completely nuke our movement speed. I don't want to use our only bomb yet because you just shouldn't. You just really shouldn't. Only use your bomb whenever you are absolutely 100% sure done with the level. This page is going to double our keys. We do have a Curse of the Tower, or a Tower card, I should say, which we can use against the boss, although we need to be a little bit careful. But really, really hoping that we get a tiers up, because that is it's a big problem. But we had an Eden run yesterday on stream where we had a decent amount of tiers and a decent amount of damage, and we still really struggled. Very, very odd. Gonna try to finagle Monstro into the middle of the room here and use the tower card. There we go. Beautiful. Not tears up, but it is a damage and range up with synth oil.
Maybe. Maybe. We can't really lose damage at this point. And getting a tears up pill would be very, very, very important. Oh. Yeah, it's just good. Give me one big old dead end there. Okay. Definitely could use a good space bar item as well. Just sort of like anything that gives us an alternate source of damage here. I mean, we're already one of three for spun. We might as well take it. I think that was okay. I mean, we gain tears. That's the thing that matters. Now the question is, do we tempt fate and use the pills as well? Unreal, isn't it? Unreal. So here's the hoping that, again, we get a tiers up pill or tiers up upgrade at some point. I am going to go into the cursed room here. Now, if you're wondering how come I'm not using the two of spades, it's because basically the two of spades right now represents, it gives us two free keys, whether or not we're on one key or zero. So we're just looking to use this one key that we currently have, unless we get like, you know, multiple keys, and it's even better. Yeah, see, this room is our freaking nightmare with 1.99 tiers. Yeah. Yep. So hang on to your hats and butts, boys and girls, because we've got ourselves one of those kind of runs, it looks like, anyway. Get a dime here. Hoping we get a PhD or something. The Hierophant card. I think there's no question about it, that we have to go for double deals on a run this bad. If we're going to have high damage, then we need to just go for the gusto. Try to get Brimstone, try to get Mom's Knife, something like that, where we can outpace the bad. Because, man, our damage is good. 6.74 is excellent. It's way above average for where we are right now. But tears being tears, yada, yada, yada. We already know what the problem is. And again, you're seeing here the beauty of having at least something go right for us in this run, which is going to be Spectral Tears and Flying. Spades. Sure, why not? And now we wait. Yeah, this is some serious problems we've got right now. It's compounded by the fact that we also only have 0.67 movement speed, and that is going to be a very dangerous situation later on in this run. You know, shot speed being shot speed, we've got good luck and everything. Well, a good luck rating. We don't have good luck. Let's not get it twisted here. This is still Sinvicta we're talking about. It's so hard to protect the bone hearts. I like that. Is a Charm of the Vampire, which is going to occasionally give us a heal every time we kill an enemy. Stanley, help us out, brother. Up, we need some desperation moves here. Our key back. I am going to go into the super secret room, and we are able to at least fill the red hearts up. To protect the bone hearts from being destroyed if we do lose them here on this here, them, there, gurglings fight. For we have three of them for some reason, and they are the yellow champion. And we're going to take full advantage of us having Flying Inspector. Take full advantage of us having Flying Inspector tiers. I'm not sure how that poop actually hit us. I didn't actually move, or at least I don't think I moved over here. Just simply going over the rock, but game says differently, so. And at times like this, when you just ask yourself, how did we get here? What led to these moments in our lifetime where we're forced just to sit back and shoot some tears at a ghoulish looking fetus thing? Ourselves a good old fashioned dad's luck up coin. Dark Bum and Lusty Blood, which are Bloody Lust. You know, Dark Bum's gonna help us out a bit. Bloody Lust will at least allow us to get some kind of damage up, but man, these tears. Oh, I accidentally picked up a red heart. I'm sorry. Soul of Bethany.
Soul of Bethany.
Justice. I don't remember what Justice does. Oh, well, it's a whole bunch of chests. That's right. Range upgrade here and a lot of money. Okay, all right now. Really hoping that we get a syringe item and at least get spun so we can get some damage. And you know what? Let's just freaking do it, Dark Bum. They say that there's a better chance to get better items down below. Let's put that to the test.
Are you a wizard?
Too many times people have said, you should go down to the ultimate path. Alternate path has better items. Huts does.
So let's figure this one out for ourselves, shall we, Dark Bum? Will going to alt path, the bad rum, give you a better chance to win?
Well, we're gonna sit here and wait. Foolishly thought that the RU the wizard pill would dissipate after us going to the next room. Floor, rather, but again, shows you what I know. I'm happy that we do have, by the way, that was the sound of Arm of the Vampire going off. Soul of Bethany making the big time play. All right, here's our first item room down here in alt path.
Okay.
Zhang Bible. I mean, happy about his damage. We've got damage. Damage is not a problem. Damage has never been the problem with this run so far anyways. Our DPS, that's the problem. Now, because we have the Satanic Bible and we've already used it, that means that we are going to get a Devil Deal item after beating the boss, which means that we are not going to get a syringe item. So, in a way, the Satanic Bible can be somewhat counterintuitive. It just kind of depends on what you need it for. What you're looking for, I should say. And Spectral Tear is a big help here. Now goes Clog. Contract from below. I think it is worth taking. And we can use Soul of Azazel against Clog in the alternate world. Or the mirrored world. Now, I should mention that I'm not planning on going to fight Mother. I'm doing this... I'm going after the key piece right now, mostly because I want to get another item off of Clog. So So just because I get this key piece does not mean that I'm planning on going to Mother, because right now this is not a Mother killing build. I just want to be totally upfront and transparent right now. I do not want to go fight Mother with this build. But the option will be there should we decide to. Need to be very cautious in this room. Talking about making some schmoves, these things here. I don't trust this room. Okay, good. Got here just in time. Let's say we do not want Little Delirium. Moving at the speed of light. We can go in the curse room for half price because we have flying. We might as well. So yeah, it's unclear whether or not we want to be doing or using the Satanic Bible until we defeat the boss, because we really need to get one of those syringe items. Like, we really do. Buy that. Just to give us an extra soul heart to start the next floor with. Oh yeah. So your time is now, Alt Path. If you wanna prove yourself to the entire world and the entire mosh pit and say, hey, you know what? I'm not so terrible after all, even if you're on a bad run, this is the run to show that. I think the operative plan currently is going to be for us to go straight to the boss if we can, or at least find the store so we can blow up a keeper. Yeah, see, fast moving mobs are not our friend for this build at all. Life imitating art. Shout out to the meme of the day. I don't know why that champion was doing that. So I'm not going to use the Satanic Bible until after we're done with this floor, which feels like a waste. But I really, really, really need a stat up. Yo, but seriously though. Arc Bomb with a speed up pill. We do get a library here. Now, I will say that the Book of Revelations, these flaming spiders. The Book of Revelations is going to be a much more suited for our needs, but it doesn't matter because we didn't get it. Yeah, 12.84 damage thanks to the Bloody Lust, and we just cannot stop taking damage. This lack of movement speed. I know it looks like I'm doing a horrible job playing right now, but even with a... That's a huge tears up for us. Even with a 0.82 movement speed, it's still very, very, very difficult to make good dodges here. So we do get a tears up, thankfully, inside the vault. I try from below and humbling bundle would be incredible for us. We're able to get that. Okay, so the best upgrade for us, period, right now would be growth hormones. I would also accept roid rage, but I would specifically want growth hormones if I could pick my next upgrade. Because that gives us movement speed, damage, and spun. We nearly doubled our tiers right here with Binky. You already see the big difference. That goes Reap Creep. We do get a movement speed upgrade, thankfully. And we get a zero devil deal. Yeah, buddy. But now we can use the Satanic Bible. I think I'm just going to start just using the Satanic Bible. It's not a good idea. But hey, that's my middle name. Doing a full clear here just because I want to see. Yeah, there we go. We need to allow Contract from Below and Humbling Bundle to work for us. So getting more consumables, getting more chests, that sort of thing. And you can already tell the difference. Just in our power curve here. We're really starting to pick up the pressure now. Now we can... Those guys were destroying us earlier. Now they can barely even get one jump off before they're dead. That is it's a good indicator just how good this build can get here with Bloody Lust. All right, so this was an extremely, extremely powerful floor for us. Very good floor, in fact. And was that the product of us going alt path? I don't know, man. I don't know. We've seen Binky inside of vaults before, but this seemed almost too good to be true. The Soul Heart range and luck upgrade. Flat Penny, sure. And just like that, this run is completely taking a new course here. Definitely deserves to be said. Shout out to Dark Bum for making this work here. Yeah, I'm missing all over the place with these secret rooms. You get a dice room. Now, if we were given the option to re-roll this run, would I? I honestly probably wouldn't at this point. Even though we're nowhere near where we would want to be. I think that we've started to put together something special here with Humbling Bundle and with Contract from Below as well. This is an in the room D20, which is basically useless for us. Yeah, literally does nothing. Careful, the yellow one is a champion. So I'm going to make the decision to use the Satanic Bible here. Again, that pretty much rules us out for getting a stat up of any kind from a normal boss drop because we're forcing a Devil Deal spawn. But the plus side is that we can't get screwed over by Stanley when he doesn't give us an item. Bongo Baby. All right, Bongo Baby's a bro. We'll take a bro. We'll definitely take Safety Scissors as well. Red Stew doesn't really help us. I mean, it helps us, obviously, but it's not imperative anymore. And we don't really mind taking too much damage currently. I'm going to go fight Pyle here. I have a 34% chance to get a deal with the Devil. I should have probably bombed the Keeper, but we only have one bomb. It didn't really make much sense to do so, especially with us already forcing a Devil deal. Start Blackheart bombing Pyle here. If he wants to damage us, we're going to punish him for it. Get Duality, which... I mean, Duality may still be good for us because we can at least get an Angel deal. Get one more scent. We can get not one, but two Soul Hearts here. Yeah, but now 14.34 damage thanks to the fully ramped up Lusty Blood is real good. Oh, I didn't need... Didn't mean to walk into the mine cart. I am going to go get the knife piece anyway. In before, this is not a mother killing build, quotes Invicta 7/13/21.
I'm so smart and snarky.
All right, people do what they feel is necessary to feel good about themselves sometimes. You know what? That's okay. Now, this being said, we still do need a Tears Up, so go ahead and yeet her off into the Yeetosphere. Want to send her upwards. Now we run. I think I'm going to do that again. And you'll see me sort of bob and weave and force Mother to go in a different direction, the one I'm operating in, or the one I'm wanting to go. It's not hard to do. There's no big secret or anything like that. You just simply make a slight little movement towards the direction that you would like her to go, and then just kind of ole and get out of the way. Still need one scent here. Take three more bombs. Oh, we have a curse room. I didn't even think about that. Duality will make it to where we can get into the Angel deal despite us getting a Devil deal. Hey, there we go. This is definitely worth the side trip. Infested. So we definitely can get ourselves two more soul hearts before going to the next floor, which is muy, muy bueno. Justice. The justice card as well, might as well. Good. This is very good. This is a very, very, very good floor. Hey. So, on to bigger and badder. Ear battered. So we don't even need to go into that room. There's really no reason to. Now, we didn't have to go down to Mausoleum 1. Could have gone back up to Depths. But again, if we're gonna try to prove a point here that you can go down to Alt Path and have a somewhat safe run. You know, this is, I mean, obviously our sample size is just one. I'm not gonna necessarily say that we've gotten ourselves in a one run situation yet. But it's certainly starting to move towards the possibility of this becoming a one run. ...73% chance now for the deal with the devil or angel. I probably would go... I don't know if I would go devil deal or not. I don't know. Let's get there when we get there. Because remember, we can still get a Devil Deal item if we use the Satanic Bible, which I don't think we've used yet on this floor, but I'm about to. Although, at the same time, we really should try to get that last syringe item. Now you're gonna sit here and tease me, game. That trip does nothing for us here. Do you like the fact that we have this permanent familiar from the Soul of Bethany? We'll come back and get all this HP, I think. Man, I don't know. More money. Troll bombs are turning into regular bombs because of the safety scissors, by the way. Basically just cutting the fuse of the bomb. And Contract from Below is just crushing it for us. Still looking for our gotta find that there them item room. There we go. This is the eternal purple globin. And then it respawns into an eternal purple globin. That's fun. Aggie's bow. We've taken the blind item almost every single time, I think, so far. We even get the bibble, which is not needed or necessary. Especially since we've already gotten Bookworm, so. Super Secret Room might be there. Yeah, that could be a very useful, well, actually more useful for us just to get the 90%. All right, if there was ever a time where we shouldn't lose a roll for a devil deal or angel deal, now's the time. Gonna pop the Empress card. We're gonna try to take down Siren. She is gonna turn Mongo Baby and the knife back at us. TJ's doesn't do anything for us. Hey, girl. Got some of that circle of protection. Love how that has now become a thing. If you don't know what I'm talking about, by the way, you'll have to see one of the live streams. Okay, so we can go back at the super battery. I don't think that there's any merit to really caring about the boss drop at this point, because that was pretty much it for bosses. There we go. So double full charge activate. We're going to head on down to Mausoleum 2. So yeah, so far so good on this one run theory that people have been talking about. I mean, we might as well get the PJs. Might as well. Calm down. Ghana too. And we really don't have to range up. Again, some more tears up would have been nice. Some more damage. Not more damage, but some more movement speed would be nice. I think those are reflecting back at us. Hard to tell. Rosary. Range down, luck up. We get Meat Cleaver. Meat Cleaver can be useful against bosses, but it does make two of them appear. Charge key. Might as well use one of our charges. Well, never mind, because we don't have the battery. That's a waste of a soul heart, but whatever. I think we're okay on HP. Surprisingly, somehow, someway, we're okay on HP. Emperor card. I was just thinking it, but I didn't want to say it. How appreciative I would be of an Emperor card here. We do get a double strength card as well. Which we can use. Actually, no, we can't, because it's the final floor. But I gotta say, consumables really have not been a problem on this run. After, I mean, it's to be expected, of course, because, you know, we got Humbling Bundle along with the Contract from Below. I mean, we've been swimming in consumables and money and everything. And I really care about this damage here. All the damage that we take is just buffing us, essentially. I do still want to find the shop, though. If for at the very least we can go just put a deposit in and get a boosted amount of double deal and angel deal chances. Did find it. Restock, which is not, you'd think that we'd be a little bit happier about that, but it's not that big of a deal at this point. Notched axe, and that's it. It still doesn't beat us getting a soul heart generator. Emperor card. Now we could, if we wanted to, we could moving box all this up and just hoover it all up. I don't think it's necessary to be honest. And I just hope that we get a devil deal here to to give us a little bit more offense if we are actually going to do Mother. That's, I don't know how we got here, but I guess we're doing it. I ain't scared. At the beginning, I was a little bit scared, but not anymore. Can you see me take advantage of Spectral Tears here? Making Mother look like a joke. And I am going to take the negative for the damage up. Get Incubus and Money Equals Power, which would have been fantastic for us earlier. But I'm going to take it anyway for the simple fact of because we have Contract from Below and Humbling Bundle, we're still going to get money, even with only two floors left. Here comes the second of the two mother fights. We're really going to have to focus on hopefully Circle Protection giving us a little bit of room to wiggle. Wish I could go back and go get those hearts and stuff, but and money, but what can you do? And yeah, we're gonna, I guess, just do it and head on down to Corpse. Here we are at Corpse. You be careful of these explosions. All right, things get considerably more serious now. So we started this run off with getting two of three syringes and then just never saw it again. Part of that can be attributed to the fact that we just used Satanic Bible over and over again. So that thereby prevented our best chances of finishing out Spun, but again, sort of like a catch 22 because it's kind of like, well, we really could use some damage here. And we need some offensive capability. And the only guaranteed thing was that we were going to get some, hopefully by way of using the Satanic Bible. And on top of that, you have to also remember that we're using it for not just that, but also for the HP generation. So there's multi layers to the whole thing. I mean, are you really going to prioritize getting Spun, or at least getting the chance of getting Spun, over, you know, getting Devil Dew items and you know, over Devil Dew items and you know, run security basically? I thought these things would go over these rocks. But they don't, I'm just saying. Here we go, another soul heart. This is where the Satanic Bible is going to shine here for us. We don't have to worry about many boss drops anymore. we're not too caring of any sort of losing any HP. We can very easily get that back with Dark Bomb and with the Satanic Bible. I mean, we still have the potential of getting a hard carry item here. Incubus was a big help for us for sure. Bad. Hold off on destroying that because the poison cloud is going to be problematic. I'm not going to play this judgment because I want the damage up from Money Equals Power. Torn card that would give us an extra secret room. At this point, I'd rather. It doesn't matter. I don't want to worry about troll bombs. Golden troll bomb here. That turned into a golden bomb. I didn't know that could happen. An HP upgrade with crack jacks. So that will, Ice Cube's actually really good. Gave us a chance to shoot out a freezing icicle tier. I believe that's what it does anyway. Yeah, there we go. All right, let's go see if it's going to be Rot Gut or not. Tower card could be very useful. We just need to make sure we don't forget. Don't forget that Emperor card. It is going to be Scourge. Oh, that's a huge freeze there. Exactly sure how we were supposed to be able to dodge that. The death list's no deal with the devil or angel. Death list is, of course, going to help us out a lot, but I mean, we're just going to go straight to, we're going to go straight to Mother at, once we get to the next floor. So, we could try to do some full clears to get the charge on the Satanic Bible, but I think we're just going to have to send it. Let's go take a quick peek about what kind of rooms we're going to be looking at here. Because again, Death's List does help out, but not at the expense of losing HP. That's a huge soul heart for us there. More money equals more damage. I mean, we can turn and burn this Emperor card whenever we want to, basically. But if we can get another stat up or two from Death's List, that's great. I just don't want to lose any HP. And since I already got lost, that's yeah. All right, well, somehow, some way, for whatever reason, we're here to fight Mother. Let's do it. Thorcore Protection, come show us why you are the cream of the crop when it comes to being all kinds of attractive and everything. It's movement speed, man. Could you not? I legitimately could not move over there. I couldn't move up. Well, we maxed out, pretty much maxed out our damage here from Unequal's power. Oh, these double hits. Keep expecting Circle Protection to stop some of those. What? I legit have no idea what hit me over here. Oh, an Eternal Heart. Thank you. So, anyway, there's that run. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. Make sure you go check out Monster Hunter Stories 2. I'll be releasing new videos for that series every single day until the conclusion of it. And then going beyond that, maybe even do an endgame PvP. Who knows? But again, thank you all very much. Hope you had a great start to your Tuesday. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thank you for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Tony and Mia, Bart Mayuzwin, Hybit Heagle, Rake 409, Matt Osman, and Cody the Wolf. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.